Hi Tango Dancer, do you think that tango music is too complicated?
Do you feel that you do not know where to start when it comes to tango musicality? In this video, we are going to simplify it for you and tell you about the four orchestras that if you are just starting out or have to focus only on four, these are the ones to know.
Hi, this is Pablo and Anne from Tango Space, where we help people to move better, to express themselves, to dance elegantly, and to meet friendly people with our tango lessons.
We know that tango musicality can feel intimidating. So in this video, we are going to help you, whether you are a complete beginner or you are a more advanced dancer, we are going to really help you simplify tango musicality and share with you the four most influential tango orchestras, the ones that you have to know and that really are going to help you understand the tango music.
So yes, in tango we have four main orchestras that we call the four pillars of the tango music. Are the orchestras that you need to know them, yes? Even if you are a beginner, you need to know these four orchestras. It's Carlos Di Sarli, Juan D'Arienzo, Aníbal Troilo and Osvaldo Pugliese.
Yes, and if you want to go deeper with us this coming weekend, we are organizing a free musicality webinar. In it, we are going to share with you secrets and tips to help you really understand tango musicality deeper. We're going to put the link in the comments so you can sign up and join us. We really look forward to seeing you there.
The first orchestra is Carlos Di Sarli. So Carlos Di Sarli famous for his nickname El Señor del Tango, es decir, of tango, and this is because it's one of the most elegant orchestras of the tango music. It's very characteristic his style, you know, for all the sophistication that there is in the music and how much refined is this music in the tango music.
So his music is relatively simple compared with other orchestra conductors, and for followers you want to really take that into account. So as Pablo said, it's all about the elegance, the melody, so as a follower you want to bring that into your dancing, but also I would recommend keeping it simple in terms of your dancing and really try to be more with the flow of the melody than adding too many decorations.
Carlos Di Sarli is an orchestra that does emphasis in the melody. So as a dancer, you want to be really with the melody of the music. And also, Carlos Di Sarli is an orchestra that will invite us to walk, yes? Because it's an elegant orchestra that we can also add poses in the dance. So it's very important to understand the musical elements for you to know how to dance.
He's very clear in terms of the phrasing that he is using in his dancing, in his music. So you will see when you go dancing socially, you are going to hear, listen to Di Sarli over and over and over again. And he has been incredibly influential on all of the melodic tango orchestras. So you really want to know about him. We're going to show you now how we dance to it, to his music, and you will see how we really put the emphasis on the simplicity, the elegance, and the melody.
Thank you.
So the second orchestra is Juan D'Arienzo.
Yes, Juan D'Arienzo, or how we call el rey del compás, yes, the king of the compás, the king of the rhythm, yes. So yes, Juan D'Arienzo is another very, very important one of the main orchestras of tango music. Juan D'Arienzo in 1935, he really created a revolution in the tango music, yes, because he took all these old tangos, old versions, and he created new versions for us, for the dancers to dance. Yes? So his music is really, you know, focalized in the dancers. Yes? He wanted the dancers to go back to the dance floor and to dance with all his rhythm.
So he brought a lot of energy and, as Pablo said, rhythm to the tango music. And because of that, he became very influential and a lot of people followed suit and not copied his style, but were inspired by him. He's really the one that, if you need to understand the elements and the concepts of rhythmic tango, this is the dancer that you want, the orchestra you want to listen to.
Yes, and as a contrast with the orchestra of Carlos Di Sarli, Juan D'Arienzo does the emphasis in the rhythm. Yeah? So it's not about the melody, how we did it with Di Sarli, it's about the rhythm.
Yeah, so now we dance one so that you can see.
Orchestra number three is Aníbal Troilo. Yes, Aníbal Troilo, or El Gordo. El Gordo means the fat one, or another nickname is Pichuco, which is a nickname that his father put on him. It's an Italian word. And yes, we also call him El Bandoneón Mayor de Buenos Aires. Yes? Why El Bandoneón Mayor means the biggest bandoneón of Buenos Aires.
The best.
The best, yes, because yes, it's considered the best bandoneon player. The bandoneon is the soul of the tango music. It's such an important instrument of this music. And yes, Aníbal Troilo played all his life this bandoneon since he was very, very small. And yes, his orchestra is very characteristic, yes, because not only because he played the bandoneon and he has a lot of solo of bandoneon in the music, if not because the contrast, yes, it's very, very rich and has a lot of contrast between melodic and rhythmic music.
It's a really rich music. It has, as Pablo said, a beautiful space for the bandoneon, and we really want to honor that when we are dancing it. You will see, again, this is an orchestra you are going to listen to and hear in social dancing a lot over and over the world, so this is one of the orchestras you want to know. So now we show you dancing one Troilo song, and you will see how we really want to showcase the beauty of the orchestra and the melancholy of the music.
Que a tus ojos que le digan tu cariño, lo perdonan. Yes, Aníbal Troilo is a famous orchestra also for his singers and the lyrics of the music. Yes, he put a lot of emphasis in the lyrics and all the lyrics in the tango of Aníbal Troilo. They are very deep, you know, very
important.
Very important. Can be melancholic, can be very, it's very, very expressive. So we as a dancers, we want to, when we dance Aníbal Troilo, we have to really be there. Yes, we have to put our heart and to listen to the lyrics and to the different contrasts that he created in the music to create different sensations in the dance.
Orchestra number four is Osvaldo Pugliese.
Yes, Osvaldo Pugliese is one of our favorite orchestras, or we call also San Pugliese, because there is a story that happened in a big concert in Argentina many years ago. There was a technical problem and one of the technicians that was trying to fix the problem for many hours that he couldn't fix it, he put a CD of Pugliese, and then all the music system start working. So since that day, in all the milongas or all the events in Argentina, we put a little picture of Pugliese because apparently it brings good luck. Yeah? So that's why it's San Pugliese. So if you are looking for luck, always have the picture of Pugliese. Pugliese, he really. His style follows Julio De Caro. Julio De Caro is one of the orchestras of the Guardia Vieja, but what happened is that Osvaldo Pugliese followed that style, but a bit more exaggerated. Yeah? So what happened with Osvaldo Pugliese is that yes, he creates a lot of drama, yes, in the music, and with a big, big contrast in the music, long pauses. So when you dance, it feels completely different than the other orchestras. It's very easy to recognize because it's very, very different, and the way that we are going to dance is different as well.
Yes, and if you are trying to make sense of tango music, sometimes it can be intimidating to listen to and dance to Pugliese because, as Pablo said, he's stretching the notes, adding more contrast, so you feel a little bit lost, especially if you are so used to dancing to Di Sarli, for example, which is very clear on his phrasing. We want to tell you, stay with it, you will see there is a lot to play with, and just have fun and try to express the drama and the creativity of the music.
Yes, with Osvaldo Pugliese is the moment that you want to expand. Yes, everything that you do, it has to be exaggerated a bit, no? A bit like the way that he plays. Everything is big, everything is more dramatic. So we are going to dance now to show you how we dance to Osvaldo Pugliese.
Este pueblo.